I don't know about the existence of God, but I do know that the soul is real. I know that the body is only a temporary vessel, a temple, a home for your soul, because that's what you really are as a soul. One proof of this is one time I was climbing with my family, which means that we go to the beach and find clams using our feet. And it was a very rocky beach because there was also blue mussels there too. And they, you know, attached themselves to the rocks. They're very, very sharp, by the way. Well, I cut my leg on one of them, and I had never felt the pain until my mom pointed it out to me. That's when I realized that the pain was unbearable. Had my mother never told me about it, I would probably never know that I was bleeding, and I would never have felt the pain. This convinced me that the body is not who we really are. Where is consciousness? Is it in the brain? I don't think so. Because if somebody got a stroke, doesn't mean that their consciousness is lost. The mind, on the other hand, I think that's the consciousness in which the soul, who we really are, possess. I think our minds are more intelligent than our brains, because our brains only control basically our senses. It controls our bodies. It determines whether you have control of your arms and legs, whether you breathe. It controls the time for sleep, your hunger, the time when you have to take a shit or a piss. Basically, that's what the brain is all about. I don't think consciousness lies in the brain. I believe it lies in the mind, which is the consciousness of the soul. So, I do believe in souls. That's without a doubt. I have many proof of this. Not scientific, more like life experience. But trying to explain to you, especially if you're a critic, would be wasting my time. You would have to experience it yourself. Those who do believe, you're not going crazy, believe me. It's all true. And that's all I have to say about the mind and the brain and consciousness and our souls, as well as our bodies.